Hello everyone, you're watching Flavours and this is Sakshi. In today's episode, we're making Aloo-Matar sandwich. This is one of my favorites and I'm very excited to share the recipe with you all. So, let's get started. Okay, so we're going to make the stuffing for the sandwich. For which I have a deep bottom pan into which I'm going to add in 1 to 2 tablespoons of oil and let that nice and heat up. Then we can go ahead and add in 2 teaspoons of cumin seeds or zira. Let that become nice and brown. And then add in 1 teaspoon of yellow hing or asafoetida. You can also use the normal white one. And once that starts to sizzle and it's nicely hot, we can add in 250 grams of chopped potatoes. Now these are quite finely chopped and I've just let them soak in water to prevent them from turning brown. So I'm just going to drain all the excess water and add in the potatoes. Now you might be wondering why I'm using raw potatoes instead of boiled ones. But the thing is that when these are like open cooked in a pan, along with a good amount of oil, they give a very nice taste indeed. And also this light chunk of the potatoes adds in a much more texture and bite into the sandwich. So we're just going to let this mix very well so that the potatoes get a good covering of the oil, and then we can cover and let this simmer for about 5 minutes on a medium flame. And we're just going to occasionally open it, and you can also add in a pinch of salt so that the potatoes cook well and more faster. So these nearly take 10 minutes or something, so we're just going to occasionally cover and open them and cook them very well. So now this version gives the best taste. That is why I strongly recommend to open cook the potatoes. And once these are 60% done, I'm going to add in 1/4 cup of green peas and 2 teaspoons of garlic and ginger paste along with a little bit of green chilies for a good flavor. We're going to give that a good mix and again cover and cook it because we want the peas to be well cooked now. And occasionally open and stir. We can also add in a splash of water, nearly 1 to 2 tablespoons, so that the mixture is well cooked and has enough water to generate a good amount of steam. So our mixture looks very well cooked and I'm gonna give it a final stir and go ahead and do the seasoning. You can see the potatoes and the green peas are very well cooked. I'm going to add in 1.5 teaspoons of red chili powder. You can increase or decrease the quantity, it's up to your preference. 1/2 teaspoon of haldi or turmeric. 2 teaspoons of garam masala. 1 teaspoon of coriander and cumin seed powder. And salt to taste. Now we already added a little bit of salt in the beginning, so we're just going to go slow with it. Then I'm going to add in 3 teaspoons of sugar. Now this mixture always tastes very good when it's slightly on the sweeter side. So we're going to add in a generous quantity of sugar and give it a good mix. Add in a little bit of water so that the masalas blend well with each other. Then I'm going to use a potato masher and mash the mixture, leaving it slightly chunky. And then add in 2 tablespoons of finely chopped coriander leaves and 1 tablespoon of lemon juice. Give it a final mix and the mixture is ready. Okay, so now it's time to assemble, and here I have 2 white bread slices over which I'm going to apply 1 teaspoon of salted butter. And then I'm just going to flip these over, and on the other side I'm going to add in some fresh green chutney into which there is some coriander, green chilies and salt and lemon juice. Once that has been applied, on the other bread, I'm going to apply tomato ketchup, 1 tablespoon of it, and spread it evenly across the entire slice of the bread. And then we're going to place a generous serving of the prepared stuffing, nearly 3 tablespoons of it, and then cover it with the other slice of bread. And just press it very well, and then on a heated pan, we're going to place the sandwich and let it well cook. Now this sandwich always tastes very good when it is toasted or grilled, so I strongly suggest to implement this step. However, you can even serve it without toasting, it's totally up to you. So we're gonna let that properly cook from both the sides. You can add an additional butter if you wish. This takes nearly 2 to 3 minutes. And our sandwich is ready. I've garnished it with a little bit of grated processed cheese. So thank you all so much for watching. Do let me know your reviews and suggestions in the comments section below. This is Sakshi signing off. Bye!